Hello again, everyone. Lev and I are back with another GvG commentary, this time between... Who is it between? Virtua Donkeys and A Farewell.
Yeah.
Alright, let's go.
It's a Swiss game.
Yeah, so this was the last Swiss round, I believe.
Yep, both teams were 4-0. And so that was like the game to determine the winner of Swiss rounds.
Yep, so VD running a pretty safe build. It's double Mesmer, Lightning Surge, 2 front, with a Wastrels. Yeah. And AF running Dervish, 2 Ellie, 2 Mes, which is the double Lightning Surge build. So you don't see this build very often, but it can be a pretty strong build. I'm not a big fan of it, I actually don't like it at all in AP8, but it's so versatile running around the map. You've got so many strong 1v1 characters.
Yeah, you don't like it in AV8? Well, especially against this build that they're facing.
Yeah, I haven't played it much, but the feeling that I get from it is just that the synergy of like Lightning Surge and AV8 doesn't synergize that well with the build, I feel. Like, Lightning Surge...
The only time I played it.
Yeah, I've seen it have a lot of success, but Lightning Surge, the way that I play it, or the way that I've, you know, have experience with it, is that it plays off your team creating a lot of pressure. Like, if your team doesn't create pressure, you don't really do much. And with two lightning
really
pressures, you're sort of relying on the other lightning surge to create pressure so that you can create pressure, so... Anyway, yeah, so two lightning surges. Ironhide, aka Joe, does have actually Spirit Bond and Chain Lightning. I've seen some of this game before, and, Zinc, aka the King himself, has Patience, Spirit, and Gale. So they've got pretty much everything covered. Like, with their
Ellie. I don't like that build with Gale, though, I think. It doesn't have many damage.
Yeah, it's definitely got a lot of weaknesses, but it's got some strengths that the other Lightning Surge build doesn't have, though. You can win certain 1v1s a bit easier, like against a Ranger with Chor Unjoined, for example, or against another Lightning Surge.
Oh, yeah, I see.
It's got some strengths.
Okay. Yeah, I guess.
So, interesting thing at the start here. VD only actually has 3 damage at the stand. They have the 2 Mesmers and a Warrior, and they're almost taking down the 3 Monks of AF. Like, they got really, really close to taking down the 3 Monks there.
Wait, what the fuck?
Yeah, so VD actually has such a strong main team.
How is that Wastrel Mesmer even doing anything? Like, he doesn't have any target to camp. He's just, like, rupting Monks, I guess?
Well, the combination of the Wastrels with Shock is, like, Axe Warrior and Wastrels is very strong. And Smokey is very good at playing off that. So both the Shatters were used there on the Dervish, so he'll probably be able to get this through for free. But almost soloing, I think this is Maverick here on Mesmer. I wonder if he has a Wastrels cancel.
He doesn't?
I think he might not. I know that Math doesn't have a Wastrels cancel, so both the team's Dom Mesmers don't have a Wastrels cancel, it seems. And both of them are running E-Surge. I think that Math has E-Surge with Complicate and P-Leak, so he's got like no energy management as well, so super susceptible to Wastrels.
Shisha clearing the footies, is he gonna take a death for it? Oh my god.
Oh, I missed that. Wow.
That shouldn't have happened. Like, their flag was like close in range, and not a... Oh my god, they're crumbling for that.
Yeah. So one thing about this build is, because you've got so many strong 1v1 characters, if you can split up the map, and they had it split in 3 ways before, where they had Flagstand, Front Door, and Back Door, it's so strong when it splits up the map. Like,
I think the big mistake VD made was running on their flag here, because it made their main team die, and it basically also made Honk and Brent die right now to 2 L-Surges. Like, you really don't want to run on Flagger against such a team, like...
Yeah, you need the Flagger to be able to respond to, like, everything that the split can do.
That could actually be game at, like, fucking 4 minutes, if they manage to time a Monk or something.
Yeah, well, luckily for VD, they did actually manage to get the flag in there with their number 8. Like, if they didn't get the flag in there, they would have been even way further behind, because AF would have boosted off this.
Fair enough, yeah. They're not able to get a kill through, like, 6v8.
This is why, this is why I don't really like the build in AV8. Like, it's pretty hard for them to score kills. I mean, VD does a very good job of staying alive here, but Shisha goes for the footman, it goes down.
Fuck, mate.
Yeah, there's really not much reason to be making such a risky play when you have two characters dead and your team's under huge pressure.
For 6v8, yeah, I might as well just go kill footy through two lightning surges.
Yeah, so VD actually managed to keep the footman up and don't take any more deaths other than the one on Shisha there when he rushed
the
footman.
That was pretty insane, to be honest, because, like, there's no way 5 damage do so little.
Yeah, I mean, you have two guys dead, you have a flag advantage, and you rush footman through double lightning surge, double mez, as a dervish. It's like suicide.
What's pretty insane is that they didn't take any kill besides this one.
Yeah.
So basically, all they got is, like, one death on a derv. And they're late on flag now, so yeah, not good exploitation of like 6v8 from AF, I think.
Yeah. So we see AF even getting a little bit low again, just to the dervish and the two mesmers, really. It's such
How
a strong combination.
Well, they still, yeah, just. What's good about the two lightning surges is like if you run one of them. And, like, he can push the enemy derv through, like, this kind of, like, corridor. And it forces their flagger to follow. Like, he's probably gonna do it now, number 3 from AF.
Yeah.
He's gonna push the derv.
Yeah, like, the biggest advantage of having all these lightning surges, you split them up in 3 ways. You have two guys that cannot be soloed by anyone on VD's team.
Yeah.
Like,
so
watch this bit,
number
watch this
three.
Bit. And watch this bit. First.
What's going on? The main team?
No, the flagger, killing. Which is fake the lightning surge, get the cure hex out, then use the lightning surge again with no cure hex because he faked it out.
Shh.
Now watch this. Gale on the healing burst.
Is he gonna get soloed? Nah.
That was a fast recharge on lightning surge as well. Gale on the healing burst again. Covers the lightning surge with the L strike there. Gale on the healing
Holy
burst again.
Shit.
Get soloed by Zinc.
Oh shit. I didn't expect that.
Yeah, I mean, that's the risk of playing flag with that spirit bomb.
Because
you can get punished by lightning surge. And by Elias. The problem is with the Gale, of course, and he'll have a lot of trouble taking me out Grand Tier on Wastrels because he'll lack a lot of damage.
Yeah. I mean, it happens, but I think you shouldn't have taken
well, yeah,
this kill.
It's definitely very rare to happen, but yeah, VD
just
getting put on the back foot again.
We all have that.
Yeah, I mean, not running Spirit Bond, sometimes when you get away with it, it's really, really strong because you get like an extra skill like Chilling Hands. And a lot of games,
yep.
Spirit Bond will not help you at all on Flagger, but in some
exactly.
games, like
so
in this
I
one.
I like Aegis over Spirit Bond.
Really? Okay.
Yeah, I don't know.
One of the problems with Aegis is, well, you can't use it on yourself, and you also can't use the NPCs, so it's kind
yeah,
of limited.
True, I guess. I wouldn't take it for, like, split games, but in AV8, Spirit Bond is so fucking useless against builds like Necrobalance and stuff.
Yeah, totally. You can never use it against Necrobalance, really. Otherwise, it's just a giant waste of energy.
Again, like, AF is just creating all those situations, and they're not able to get much from them, because... Why are they even trying to split at that point? Like, they should go all out with 5 of their damage on the 2 monks of VD.
Yeah, Honk is doing a good job at sort of keeping Joe back, but Joe should really just be letting Honk split right now, I feel.
Yeah.
Letting him take the back footman.
They should just use, yeah, just leave it or use your flagger.
Yeah,
I guess they're trying to secure a boost, maybe, but they already boosted, so that doesn't make much sense.
Yeah, they could have made a lot more out of that than they did.
Yeah.
So yeah, Honk is just baiting Joe at the back.
I'm surprised AF didn't run that build when he faced HDHR in like single elms. Because they seem to
what
be
did they run?
Okay with it. They ran like Ranger Necro Ellie and they got steamrolled.
That was on Frozen, right?
Yeah. Ranger Necrorelli is such a hard build to play, like, it's very hard.
Yeah, it's extremely aggressive, though.
And I think, it, like, in some situations, it's not even viable. Like, you just can't win.
Really? I feel like it's a pretty like balanced build, I'd say. I actually like the build quite a lot. But yeah, it's kind of hard to play.
I think it's the real balance. Necro balance is just a gimmick.
Yeah, like Necro balance has no chance to deal with split builds, basically. Unless you get lucky or the other team sucks.
Unless the other team is BG.
Anyway. So, Brent did return the flag there, which means the VD will have a bit of a flag advantage. They actually have a flag here on Shisha, which they'll need to pass off. So they're a full flag ahead, which is just the best news in the world for VD. Like, they can keep all their damage together now, and AF has to run through them. But nothing to notice is that AF is not utilizing the front door right now. Like, they're not splitting up VD very much. Instead, they're actually trying to run on Ellie, which is the character that could be pushing front door.
Wow, running on Ellie like that through two mesmers, that's suicide, clearly.
Yeah, it's not just, like, it's more than suicide as well. It means that you can't split up the map. Like, the Dervish can run through front door, but it can get followed by a Monk and you can't do anything because you have no power to kill a main team. Like, you need the Dervish at main team because this Ellie can't do any damage at main team. As soon as he starts doing damage, he just gets shut down by two mesmers. So if they want to do damage, they need the Dervish here. But yeah, the Dervish is going to push front door. I just get followed by the Monk and it does nothing.
Yeah, that's true.
So it's risky and it puts them at the back foot because they can't split up the map properly.
It's a big stalemate at the back door between Joe and Hong.
Joe has, I'm pretty sure Joe has, he has Spirit Bond, so he should, he could be taking this footman if he wanted to through Hong.
Actually, that's a valid point, like he's playing really safe. There's no way the Mystic Eldritch can win against the Spirit Bond, even if you have like lightning armor.
So Zink is trying to run the flag again, which is
I think that's
kinda
their
weird
mistake. Like they should definitely stop running on Ellie.
Yeah, like this time VD is really taking advantage of her, pushing all the way up to the front door. So if he wants to try and run the flag, he has to run all the way up to the bridge and then through the bridge.
Yeah.
Which is going to be basically impossible.
He's going to get his Windborne shattered and he's going to get Wastrel spam, so he's going to have to use like Patient every 3 seconds.
Yeah.
And it's really unoptimal. He's getting Rupted on his Windborne, yeah. Why would you do that when you have a Mesmer with Dash?
Yeah, I mean, they could run on Mesmer, they could run on Dervish. I mean, Mesmer would be really good to run on. Because the Dervish could do damage while you run on it. And they're pushing front door with Dervish now again.
Push the Dervish front door?
It's just getting followed by the Monk, and it's not, like, this Monk is a free character right now, it's not doing anything, so following the Dervish does not hurt VD at all.
Yeah.
Looks like he got full blocked there for a second. Backs out of it there. This is just so risky. It's like they're trying to bait Honk at the back door. They're trying to collapse on him. The Mesmer and Ellie, but it looks like they get out of it.
It's happening! Oh no, never mind. It could be. Well job, Honk.
I mean, he can't get this flag in. He has to just drop it and they have to try out something else.
I think they found the way, like, defend it though. Like, because the moment you don't use a Monk to defend one of their split Ellies, it means that your Monk will not be split three ways, and so you're already way more safe.
Yeah. Well, yeah, if you can defend 1v1 with an Ellie,
yeah.
The three-way split thing is a lot less effective.
But still, like, they could still make moves with the Ellie and sneak out NPCs and stuff.
Yeah.
But
so they
trying
do
to get
drop the flag there. They dropped it and get a return, so it looks like. Yeah, they're not, it looks like they're not even trying to run now. The Dervish is not trying to run. The Mesmer is defending split for some. I don't understand that at all. Defending split against the Ellie?
Yeah, I don't know. Maybe they thought like they should have their two Ellies at main. I don't know.
But the two Ellies are going to get countered so hard by the two Mesmers of VD.
Exactly, yeah. I think they really got turtled by just trying to push this flag on the Ellie so bad.
Yeah. Trying to push the flag on the Ellie and not opening up the map.
Yeah.
Honk is now collapsing the main and the Mesmer is following him. There's definitely a boost for VD now, which is great news for them. They've already boosted actually.
The thing is that Mesmer can't just like, he can't get too close to Honk or he's just gonna get soloed.
Yeah, I think the Honk could even kill NPCs through him if he really wanted to.
I don't know. Maybe. So now he's going for 2 damage split, which is not going to achieve anything. Does he have Spirit Bond on 3?
No, he has Patient Spirit.
So
but
yeah,
I mean,
they
I think that
have
this 2 damage split could pay off, but they need to split Front Door at the time for it to pay off. Because this is, you know, this is taking up the month of VD, right? So
that's
this means
good,
that the front door is open. And they have nothing to defend
definitely.
The push front door with. Like, what are they going to defend? Wastrels?
Like, they could actually just push Derv through. Oh, Shisha. Again.
Goes for the knights and get second down.
Well, that was not his fault, I guess. And, yeah, they didn't try to take advantage of 30 DP under Derv earlier in the game. Well, now they boosted, so it's different, but.
But that's the thing, though, is that you it's, without pressure up, it's really hard to take advantage of it. Like, you need at least a little bit of pressure up, and then you can kill it anytime you want with the Mesmer's and Lightning Surge. But if you can't get pressure up, they can just spam Protzen the whole game.
That's a good point, though. Like, if they engage, like, in a two-man split at the back door, and they just push, like, their Derv through front door, like, Ellie, VD will have to use their prod, because really, they have no other good character for
yeah, exactly. They just need
and
to.
Then they would have their monks split 3 ways.
Yeah, they need to open up the map. Like, they just not doing it very effectively.
Yeah, so that makes me think this build is actually really good. Like 2 L surges, because
on a really open map, sure.
It's one of the best builds to actually play against those builds, and you still can create some openings, but imagine against like Necro Balance or something.
Yeah. She's just trying to catch out this Mesmer, but it's gonna be pretty difficult considering how far away he is. But this Mesmer's just doing nothing right now. I don't understand the idea behind having the Mesmer at the back door 1v1 in the alley.
Yeah, that's really, yeah, they're basically fighting 7v8 now, and now he's gonna get collapsed on. Well, he PI'd Honk, so he saved himself.
Yeah, he got 3 of Honk's skills out, but he's still gonna be in a bit of a risky spot. He's gonna take a bit of damage. Honk's skills gonna be back up in a second, but Honk's actually going back to split. He could have killed the Ellie here, but goes back to split a little bit early.
Well, he's gonna defend, yeah. He could have gave up those footies, maybe.
You see the 1v1 now between
though,
the Gale,
like,
LS. See, this is
the Gale, yeah. Like, he's got an opening, but he's probably not gonna get this footy because of the low damage on his bar.
Yeah. I feel like this is one of the strengths of the Gale LS, though. He just uses Gale on the Lightning Surge of Honk, but Honk did cancel it, though, as the Gale was coming in. But I feel like this should
That's
be a really
okay.
easy fight for Zink to win.
I don't think. I mean, the problem is Zink is not gonna be able to kill Honk, so he's just gonna exhaust himself.
He,
Gale.
He got
like,
the Gale on the LS, though.
If Honk can survive like 30 seconds, well, he's taking more damage than I expected. But now he's fine. I mean, if he's able to get his LS through.
Yeah.
Why is he taking so much? How can you take 116 on shield set?
Well, he just has blessed armor. Actually, he might not have a lightning shield as well, I'm not sure. Actually, I think he does have a lightning shield based on the damage he's taking.
Basically. Well, probably, I mean.
But yeah, you're right. He could get away a bit. If he got. I feel like if he got caught out, like, if Zink actually went and engaged him in the open, like, not near the footman, he might have been able to get the kill there.
Yeah, but Lao, like, Zink is probably way exhausted now. Honk could
yeah.
probably, like, just push on him.
Yeah, that's true.
Because if Honk plays offensive, he's gonna force him to use his Gale, otherwise he's just gonna die because he's got patient.
Hey, if he's coming on the flag now. Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
Shit, going for those knights. There's no way this flagger is gonna hold them. No way at all.
The Shisha, I mean, Kai could actually get the flag in right now. I think that Smoke is probably running a bit low on energy. Yeah, just use Shock twice and Bull Strike. So he should be able to get this flag in, I think.
Yeah, he's gonna get it in, but.
Oh, actually, it's another Bull Strike!
Oh,
that
my.
Was very close. Yeah, he's gonna get that in
That's
now.
Well played by Sebi, I think, to keep him up.
Yeah, very well played. Map is getting quite low at the front door.
But
they
kind of managed to get out of this situation somehow.
Well, they run on Dervish, is what they had to do a lot earlier. They need the flag stand to split them up 3 ways. If they don't use the flag, then they can only split them up 2 ways, which can get countered like really, really easily.
And now Kai returns the flag. No, that's good. They returned the situation.
Yeah, they just need to keep capping the flag, because they need AF, so they need VD to keep running, and they need that 3 points on the map. Like, and now they can run on Lightning Surge as well. Their running options have opened up so much now that they've got the flag in a push front door. Like, they could sit a Lightning Surge up the flag stand running flag and, you know, kill Shisha when he runs a flag through like this. Because VD just has nothing to run the flag on, like, while they're defending with Honk.
Yeah, that's true.
I mean, they would have to run on the monkey and the number 8 monk, but last time that happened, he got soloed. I mean, obviously he'd be a lot more careful about that next time and probably not get soloed, but it's still not a very, you know, it's not ideal to be running a flag like that.
Yeah. I don't know, like, they should probably break this 1v1 at the back door, because it's not doing anything for them. For AF, I mean.
Yeah. I mean, they got the footman down, I guess. I didn't see if that was through the Ellie, but...
I mean, yeah, but it's not worth, like, the 3 minutes he's been there for.
See, Zinc just ate the pin down, but the Mesmer's gonna be there though now.
Yeah, but the flagger's already there, also.
Yeah, that's true.
So that's a good follow, my killing.
Zinc eats the full range pin down.
Yeah, AF is back in the game.
But VD's running the flag for free though on the Dervish. This is such a free push for Joe.
Yeah, I feel like Joe could just be sitting at the flag stand.
Yeah, Joe should be running flags.
Yeah, in this situation, that's the only time maybe it's worth it to run on Ellie.
Yeah, it's like on Solitude. Like, when you're splitting on Solitude, you want to be running flag on an Ellie if you're not getting pushed on, because that lets you control the flag stand. Just like on Uncharted, yeah. If you run an Ellie, you can control the flag stand.
They shouldn't break the 2v2 backdoor now, because they had the killing backdoor, which was good.
Yeah, holding the Monk backdoor was doing great for them. It was it was forcing them to run a Shisha.
Yeah. They basically have to think about lower damage at that point, because AF just doesn't have any DP on the enemy and no NPCs down whatsoever. Like, they did nothing, basically.
They've got flag disadvantage now as well, which is very bad. Just letting VD get into the spot again where they have so much damage together in one spot at the front door. This is the ideal spot for them to be in.
Yeah. It's crazy how, like, can be reverted super quickly.
Yeah.
Like, AF scored like tons of kills and they just let the enemy boost twice and they're back to square one. So I guess going for NPCs might be like a safer option when you're in a split build like that. Or like not letting the enemy team boost. I don't know.
Yeah. Joe getting quite low to Brent there. Need to use Spirit Bottom the night, or the night's gonna die.
Yeah, what the fuck, Joe?
No. Looks like Brent is gonna get out of this as well. Great job by Brent there. Fantastic job. Even if he used Spirit Bomb on the night though, it would have just gotten shattered straight away. So that was a fantastic play by Brent.
Well, Spirit Bomb is like 5 second recharge, so if you use
Well, yeah, he should have tried at least.
Yeah.
See Honk in the open against Zinc again. He gets galed on the Lightning Surge from fast cast gale.
Yeah, no doubt it's pretty nasty, but I don't think it's you can't get NPCs through another L-Surge.
Yeah, you're right that if Honk just runs away when Zinc starts using Gale, like, Zinc has to Gale himself out to even have a chance of getting Honk away.
Yeah. He just has to get his L-Surge through and run.
Yeah. So Kai did get the flag in, so it puts AF into the ideal spot again. And they're running on the number 8 now, though, instead of running on...
They really didn't take advantage of their position by, like, pushing the flag runner of VD.
Yeah. I mean, VD's running on Mesmer now, so they only have one Mes main, so Joe could get something done main now. They could get some damage off. They
have, really like, 3 damage against... I don't know, they have 4 damage against 3 monks. I mean, that's not gonna kill.
Oh, yeah, fair point. Pretty impossible to kill through this. Like, the damage, yeah, the damage is gonna come from, what, like, a lightning surge and a dervish. That's, like, yeah, the most obvious damage in the world.
And both back lines are pretty good, so, like, they're not gonna take death stupidly like that. I really feel as though VD could just, like, push in an AF base.
Yeah.
Once they get flag advantage.
I mean, while AF runs at number 8 now, it would be a perfect opportunity to run in and steal some NPCs. I feel.
Yep, definitely. They should let this guy go through, like, not even hit him.
Yeah, like, it's gonna be so hard to kill him, just let him run through and just take advantage of the fact that he's running flag. He does drop the flag, though, and looks like AF might not be trying to even run now. Yeah, AF is just giving up on flag, it looks like, and going all out for NPCs now. I feel like that's a bit of a mistake, because it means that VD doesn't have to run flags in response. Like, you kind of want VD to run flags so you can take advantage of it.
I think they should, like, one more flag in at least.
Well, yeah, if they get another flag in, VD would have to run, right? And we'll let them have an opening on the front door. Like, they could take advantage of the fact that VD is running to have an extra player on the map and kill some NPCs with it.
Well, VD could just say, fuck it, and I'll let them boost, because, what, that build has, like, one reses or two max.
Yeah. Okay, going for the knights now.
They can't just send one dirt, they need to send more damage.
You got the lightning surge coming now, but it's not going to be enough, they need even more than this. Especially since Honk's going to be here in a second to defend, it's going to be impossible to get anything through the Wastrels and the Lightning Surge. It's going to be a very strong defense from VD, and kind of a weak offense from AF.
One light down, though. That's good.
So AF is sending the Wastrels now, but with only one month pushing. Two knights down.
Yeah.
But they've still only got one month pushing. It's going to be very hard to push the pit.
The thing is, like, VD is playing right, leaving their L Surge as a defense, because their Wastrel, I mean, because they know for sure there's going to be at least one L Surge coming to their Lord, and the fucking Wastrel is just going to destroy him, especially the Gale one. Like, he's got no energy.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got no energy, and he's getting camped by Brent here.
Yeah, so that's, like, neglect, like, basically one player doing nothing.
Yeah, if we see, like, one Rupt right now on Little Green Noya, it could be a death. In fact, they just die there anyway on the Dervish, because he gets land back by Lightning Surge.
Yeah, that Mesmer should have hit Honk instead of hitting the Lord.
I think he was trying to Rupt Honk, but it's just, like, the full pit and two damage characters, you can't tank that with just one monk.
Yeah.
So here comes the pack.
Yeah, then same mistake in VG, like AF is leaving only one damage in their base. And so that's very bad, because is leaving only one damage in their base.
Yeah, so I doubt.
Just sit on the Lord for free.
Gets the pack though. Still so low though, they still only have one monk.
Yeah,
so.
But that's not gonna do anything.
Yeah. It's not gonna
At
do anything when they have one.
It's like 10 seconds away.
Yeah.
And they're dying.
So Lightning Surge defending might res it. Yeah, just one Lightning Surge defending. It's just like, it doesn't do anything. Just gets countered by one monk and the Rupts from the Mesmer.
I think if they didn't let VD boost, and Shisha would be like 45 or 30 DP by now. And it wouldn't sit on the Lord, like, as easily.
Yeah, I feel like the biggest mistake was just the running flags and not opening up the map very well. But it was a really good game though, like, very back and forth.
Yeah, well played to VD.
Yeah, I'd say well played to both teams. And congratulations to VD. Alright, thanks for watching.